50 years ago, the world was a very, very different place. I was a young television producer, and I decided that I wanted to start making natural history films. And I went to the London Zoo. And since I didn't know anything about Africa, Asia, or anything else except Britain, I thought there would be somebody there who might help me to find my way through the natural world. And indeed there was a marvellous man who was a curator of reptiles called Jack Vester. And together we cooked up an idea which would be absolute anathema today. We decided that we would go to the London Zoo to catch animals in the wild and bring them back to the London Zoo. Now these days you wouldn't dream of doing that. Responsible zoos breed their animals. Responsible zoos know perfectly well that the stock of animals in the wild is limited. It is not infinite. We went to Madagascar. I tried to find out about Madagascar from the French, and there was no film, no natural history film at all made in Madagascar. And those wonderful ranges of lemurs, which you will have seen, and which tourists go and visit today, had never been seen on television. And I have had all my life a passion for Birds of Paradise. And nobody 50 years ago had filmed wild Birds of Paradise displaying in the wild. One of the great mind-blowing experiences and scenes of the natural world. And it took us 3 months before we managed it. And we walked into valleys where no Europeans had been before. And it was an extraordinary, unforgettable time. How things have changed today. A mere 50 years. And why? There is one huge change that has taken place in those 50 years. And that is that there are more than twice as many human beings on this planet today as there were then. There were just something over 2 billion in 1954. Now there are more than 6.5 billion. And the consequences of those, of course, of that change has been enormous. This huge expansion in human beings has also demonstrated a very extraordinary fact of Homo sapiens, which is that Homo sapiens loves to aggregate. It loves to live together. And thank goodness, because if it didn't, there would be no wilderness. If we all demanded 5 hectares or whatever it is, we wouldn't be able to exist. But the consequences of that is that the majority of the population of this planet, some like 80%, are urbanized. And 80% are getting further and further away from the natural world. Another consequence of this huge expansion of our numbers, of human numbers, has been climate change, which you've all heard about. And that brings more problems. We have a responsibility to make sure that people know about the natural world. And paradoxically, they do. People know more about animals on this planet today than they have ever done before, even though they are less in touch.